I think when a kid walks in, their first thought is, holy cow, what's this place all about?
If any kid walks in the door, chances are they're gonna see something, and boom, you can see the spark in their eye.
Asking questions, making observations are all a higher level of what's natural for humans to do in the first place.
I like the work of the kids, see them be happy about the things they have created themselves.
As soon as I came in, I just sensed a spirit of creativity and energy, and I'm thinking, boom, this place is magical for children.
We sometimes think of science as things that happens in a classroom or in a laboratory. Actually, science is something that can be part of an everyday, healthy way of being.
For us, science is more about a way to be connected to the world, and there's also this side of it that's creative. If you have an idea, this is a space where you can come and you can bring your ideas to life.
There's liberty to be creative, to be imaginative, to discover, to explore, to experiment.
When I first heard about the science workshop movement, I was just amazed that there could be a space where you could have, you know, both tadpoles that you're looking at under the microscope and power tools.
We try to meet people where they are. And so if a kid doesn't really want to look at the bearded dragon, they don't have to. If they don't want to build a circuit, they don't have to.
And I think that's really important for kids to feel like it's all up to them.
A lot of our stuff isn't what you typically see in a science laboratory or a classroom.
The difference with science workshops is that these materials are just out. So they're open, they'll approach this object and they'll just start asking questions. And suddenly, their knowledge is forming and they understand how their previous experiences in the world are relevant. We have a wood shop with a wide range of power tools. We have a whole lot of take-apart electronics.
We have some turtles, we have a bearded dragon, we have two snakes.
Kids like animals and they get to help create their environments and be right in front of the animals and feel and smell and hear them.
They try to provide the supplies and provide the environment for kids to do whatever they can dream up.
There is a huge disparity still between the haves and the have-nots. What we have here is a grassroots effort.
We're really trying to remove as many barriers as possible.
Children who may not be academically the superstars can have such a creative imagination that in a place like this, they can thrive. And that becomes a measure of not so much how smart are you, but how are you smart?
We are located in an area that's a lot of low-income housing, and we have a lot of people that just walk through the space.
They're gonna see friends, they're gonna see people with a similar background, and they're gonna feel like it's a space where they belong and where they can develop as a person.
So we're called Free Science partly because kids are free to be authors of their own education, but we're also free because we don't charge admission. Participants can just walk in and there's no membership fees, no entry fee.
Everyone can be a scientist and everyone should have the equal opportunity to access science.
One of my favorite projects was working with a group of kids to make a vending machine. The kids had to identify problems as they came up and come up with ways to solve them. And they pushed through and they had this moment at the end when they were showing it off and they were so proud.
There's a young boy who is building an exact replica of Paul McCartney's bass guitar. All these engineering skills are coming out of this project of his. That sort of drive is something that you just wanna like capture and keep going.
One of the boys decided that he wanted to make a boat, and we talked about how it's possible to make a boat out of cardboard. So there's a lot of excitement around, you know, whether or not this is gonna float. It was so exciting to put it in the water and see all that hard work come together.
I can imagine that there are children who will come in here and discover some things about themselves and their interests that literally can be life-changing in terms of how they think about themselves as a learner.
Not a lot of places, you know, you get to have your child use a power tool or your child gets to hold a snake, doing things that might look dangerous or might look messy, but that's how kids learn and get really excited about different things they might not have known they were excited about by experiencing it with all their senses.
opportunities like this that create those types of experience for young people are one of the best investments that we can make, because we're really talking about things that can ultimately be transformative in the life of a child.